Very much to our pipers this morning for commencing our carol service. And I would like to warmly welcome everyone this morning to Cookstown High School annual carol service. And I would particularly like to thank the Reverend Greer and also the session of Molesworth Presbyterian Church for the use of their building once again this year and for their ongoing generous support. In advance of the service, I would also like to thank pupils, staff, the PTFA, and the former Pupils Association and Scripture Union for their involvement in our service this morning. Whether it's in readings, music, the organisation, and presenting the Christmas message, I extend my thanks to you. It is the time of year where we remember the birth of our Saviour, the Lord Jesus Christ, and the great news of his atoning sacrifice for our sins. And we're now going to have our senior choir with Pippa Coulter and Caitlin Hood, and they are going to sing Light of the World.
Light of the world, treasure of heaven, brilliant like the stars in the wintry sky. Joy of the Father, reach through the darkness, across the earth. Light light of the world, treasure of heaven, brilliant like the stars in the wintry sky. Joy of the Father, reach through the darkness, shine across the earth, send the shadows to flight.
Light of the world, from the beginning, the tragedies of time were no match for your love. From great heights of glory, you saw my story. God, you entered in and became one of us. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah for the things he has done. Come and adore him, bow down before him, sing hallelujah to the light of the world. Light of the world, crown in a manger, born for the cross, to suffer, to save. High King of heaven, death is the poorer, we are the richer by the price that he paid.
Thank you. Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2, 6, and 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in a land of darkness, on them light has shone. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there will be no end. On the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with righteousness and justice. From this time forth and forevermore, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 16. And in the same region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased." When the angel went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see the thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger.
Breaks a new and glorious birth. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus rising, let all be praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord. Praise his name forever. His power and glory.
A reading from John chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to bear witness about the light, that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to bear witness about the light. The true light, which gives light to everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own people did not receive him. But to all who did receive him, who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, who were born not of the blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Christ is born for you.
tender and broken, come with fears unspoken, come, taste of his perfect love. Oh, come, guilty and hiding ones, there is no need to run. See what your God has done. Christ is born. Christ is born. Christ is born for
A reading from Matthew 2, verses 1 to 12. Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose, and have come to worship him." When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And assembling all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it is written by the prophet. And you, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod summoned the wise men secretly and ascertained from them what time the star had appeared. And he sent them from Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word that I too may come and worship him." After listening to the king, they went on their way, and behold, the star that they had seen when it rose went before them until it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy, and going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed to their own country by another way.
Thank you. Have you ever seen a rainbow and wanted to follow it to get to the other end? Or have you ever seen on the internet these crazy tornado scientists that follow tornadoes? Or have you ever looked up into the sky and saw a big, bright, shining star? But I would guess that when you see that star, you don't want to follow it or study it. However, in the Bible, it was different. In Matthew chapter 2, it tells the story of the wise men during the birth of Jesus. In this chapter, we see that these wise men knew that this star was special. They knew that the star was a sign from God, and they trusted him and followed the star. Then they were led to Jesus, and they worshipped him and presented him with gifts. However, along the way, they encountered Herod, who plotted to kill Jesus. But God warned the wise men not to go back to Herod. God protected Jesus.
So how can we apply this story to today? As Sarah has already said, the wise men followed the star to their destination. But in our walk with Jesus, he is our star, and our destination is heaven. As the wise men were tempted to return to Herod, similarly, in our modern world, I'm sure you would agree, there are plenty of distractions which divert our attention from the correct direction we need to take. We may be busy with work or with sports, or as much as we may hate to admit it, our phones can even be a distraction at times. These wise men were shown visions to help them make the right choice. With us, God has given us the Bible for us to study to help make the right choices in our lives. In Proverbs chapter 4, verses 25 to 27, it says, "Let your eyes look straight ahead, your gaze directly before you. Give careful thought to the paths for your feet and be steadfast in all your ways. Do not turn to the right or the left. Keep your foot from evil."
Finally, as the wise men followed the star to find their way, in our lives, Jesus is our star. If we ever feel like we get distracted by the things of this world, if we ever feel like we have become lost or lose our sense of purpose, we can always look to Jesus. He is our direction, he is our purpose, and he is our salvation.
Folks, our destination might not be a manger in Bethlehem, but it's just as important. Our destination should be eternal life in heaven, but there's only one way. Just like there was only one way the wise men could have known how to find Jesus, just like there's only one way for us to get to heaven. Trust Jesus. It all comes back to trusting Jesus.
In John chapter 14, verses 5 to 7, it says, "Thomas said to him, 'Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way?' Jesus answered, 'I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really know me, you will know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him.'"
Just as the wise men found Jesus because they followed the star, we can find salvation and eternal life in heaven. All we have to do is trust Jesus with our lives and follow him. Thank you for listening. Stay safe and have a wonderful Christmas.
Let us pray. Father God, when your precious son became a tiny baby in a stable in Bethlehem, in poverty and simplicity, you changed our world. As we imagine those surroundings, we join with the shepherds and the wise men in wonder and praise. We thank you for our material lives, praise you for our spiritual lives, and trust in you for our eternal life. Amen.
Dear God, we thank you for the message of peace that Christmas brings to our distracted world. Give peace among the nations, peace in our land, peace in our homes, and peace in our hearts, as we remember the birth at Bethlehem of the Prince of Peace, Jesus Christ our Lord. Father, we pray that the joy of Christmas may fill our hearts with a new and deeper sense of your love for us and for your world, and that we may reflect your love by serving those in need for his sake who came to be the Saviour of us all, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Loving Father, help us remember the birth of Jesus, that we may share in the song of the angels, the gladness of the shepherds, and the worship of the wise men. Close the door of hate and open the door of love all over the world. Let kindness come with every gift and good desires with every greeting. Deliver us from evil by the blessing which Christ brings, and teach us to be merry with clear hearts. May the Christmas morning make us happy to be thy children, and Christmas evening bring us to our beds, with grateful thoughts, forgiving and forgiven, for Jesus' sake. Amen.
A Christmas Day prayer. Little baby Jesus was born on Christmas Day, lying in a manger laid upon soft hay. His mother Mary cared for him, his dad Joseph felt proud. To be given such a special boy, they felt safe within God's plans. Shepherd came to greet him, wise men carried gifts, and gave them to the baby. They knew he would be king. So we too, on Christmas Day, come to worship him and celebrate with love and hope, to laugh and sing and pray. We love the lights upon the tree, the presents and the food. We share the special time together and say our God is good. So good he sent us Jesus to walk and shine the way, for us all to follow him into a heavenly day. Amen.
And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them. And the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
Sing it out. Oh, what a proud moment and a glorious night indeed. Normally the music brings me on the verge of tears, and I always blame Mrs. Gormley for picking things that are really emotional. And today, the last one just is so uplifting, and you couldn't have failed to have a smile on your face and your toe tapping. And if you were failing to do that, well, then there's definitely something wrong. I'd have to get you seen to. Good morning, and thank you all for attending our carol service. And it is a privilege and an honour to be able to round up a service that I can take very little credit for, but to be able to thank you and all the people who participated in it as a tremendous celebration of the nativity for our school community, really. And as a disclaimer, if I leave someone out, it was very much unintentional, because as most of you know, it wouldn't be like me not to stand and talk long enough to make sure I'd covered absolutely everybody before we're finished. I'm sure everyone here and who's able to see this, I think it's visible online. Are we live to the nation, Mr. Cuddy? Excellent. So I'm sure everyone who has been able to hear this morning's service would agree that the music contributions and the participation by everyone in school has been absolutely superb. Mrs. Curry just said, you must be so proud. And I think that's a thread that runs through everything that we do in school. We are so proud, but it sometimes takes you to sit back and watch and listen and remember that it's a proud occasion, but also a beautiful celebration this morning. We're grateful for the fact that Molesworth grants us permission to use the church building, and thanks to the session and committee of Molesworth for that. Thank you, Mr. Cuddy, Mr. Graham, technical assistance down in the corner, and for all your help setting up with things yesterday and the PowerPoints and making sure that we can all be seen and heard. Maybe some of you'd rather wasn't heard right now. But also thanks very much to Mr. McGoon as the former pupils, and Mrs. Curry for the PTFA representation and readings, as well as our team of senior prefects who always step up when they're asked to do anything. Thank you very much for that. And for me, as I've said, the Christmas music, it's an emotional roller coaster. So this morning has taken me from on the verge of feeling the water coming, going, oh my word, this is so beautiful, to right through to that uplifting where you get the goosebumps. So I love to experience the full range. And again, the music department never fail to bring me to the verge. So thank you very much to Mrs. Gormley and Mrs. Blackwood and all of the talented musicians. And I can't go without saying thanks also to Dr. Morgan, tucked in there at the organ, and to Theo, keeping us in time. It's not an easy job. I mean, keeping me in time, Theo, was very challenging. We are, as a school, awash with talent, and it is a very proud morning Thank you very much also to Miss Hannah and the Senior Scripture Union, to Theo and to Sarah. And also, if you were able to attend our Senior Scripture Union event last week, I have to say, again, they've brought me to a whole new musical repertoire. My Christmas music repertoire now extends to Come All Ye Unfaithful. I'm so glad that that featured this morning as well. And the confidence and the maturity that those young people approached that this morning, I just want to underscore, we don't take for granted how difficult it is to stand up and perform in front of your peers. So I'd like to thank every one of them for their confidence and the way in which they did that this morning. And the pipers as well, we couldn't forget them and the string group. So thank you very much to our guests, to our parents and Cookstown High School friends and family who came along this morning. I think it would be appropriate to show your appreciation for everyone who put on this splendid carol service this morning with a little round of applause, please. And last but not least, on behalf of the staff and the pupils of Cookstown High School, I'll take this opportunity to wish you all, visitors and school community, a very happy Christmas. Let's hope that brought you the festive feeling that some of us maybe have been missing up until this morning, and a peaceful new year. And thank you very much for coming. And if our visitors, Cookstown High School, if we let the visitors leave first, and then the rest of us will leave on direction of the form tutors. Merry Christmas.